Welcome to Manifested Publishers.
Welcome, learners, in our today's biology lesson. Today we continue with the process of fertilization. My name is Stephen Kariungi. Now, so we are going to look at the process of double fertilization in flowering plants. So last time we talked about the structure of gametes, the male gametes and the female gametes, and we say that those are the cells that are involved in fertilization. Today, we are going to discuss double fertilization. But before we discuss double fertilization, it is important to understand that pollination must take place first so that fertilization can follow. So now, what happens when the pollen grain lands on the stigma? When the pollen grain lands on the stigma, there are a number of processes that occur. And before we discuss those processes, we are going to have a diagram showing a pollen grain having landed on the stigma, and then we see what follows after that. So this is actually a pollen grain. That lands on the stigma. And the first thing that we said about a pollen grain, it has two nuclei. There is the tube nucleus and there is the generative nucleus. So the first thing that happens is that when that pollen grain lands on the stigma, it sticks there. So the stigma is sticky. And this pollen grain on sticking, it absorbs nutrients from the stigma and it forms or it germinates something that is called a pollen tube. So there is a pollen tube. Now, in this pollen tube, the tube nucleus takes a position at the tip of the pollen tube while the generative nucleus remains somewhere behind there. So, this process continues and the pollen tube continues absorbing nutrients from the style. Now it is growing down the style and continues to lengthen, becomes longer. Later, the generative nucleus divides into two by the process of mitosis. Note that. The generative nucleus divides by the process of mitosis. So that now, as this pollen tube is growing, we do not have now two nucleus or two nuclei. It is continuing to grow downwards, gets to the ovary, continues. And during this time, the tube nucleus takes a position at the tip of the pollen tube. while the other two nuclei arising from the generative nucleus takes a position behind there. Now, this is the embryo sac. This is the mature embryo sac containing the antipodal cells, containing the polar nuclei, we have the egg cell here, and then we have the synergids. So this is a germination of pollen tube. This is the tube nucleus, and the pollen tube enters into the embryo sac through the micropyle. We saw these parts earlier. So when the pollen tube enters the embryo sac through the micropyle, the tube nucleus disintegrates. It disintegrates to allow the two male nuclei that are behind here to fuse with the egg cell and also with the polar nuclei. This is something that I want us to explain there. Now, I want us to go back to the beginning, that when the pollen grain lands on the stigma, it sticks, or the stigma is sticky, and absorbs nutrients which leads to germination of a pollen tube. A pollen tube has germinated, or it starts to germinate. We have two nuclei there. The tube nucleus takes a position at the tip of the pollen tube. Then the generative nucleus divides mitotically, that is by mitosis, mitotically, to form two male gamete nuclei. So the generative nucleus is the one that has divided mitotically to form two male gamete nuclei. There are two, that's why they are nuclei. The pollen tube continues to grow down the style, by absorbing nutrients from the neighboring cells. So finally, this pollen tube that is growing enters the embryo sac through the micropyle. It enters the embryo sac through the micropyle, and the tube nucleus disintegrates. The tube nucleus disintegrates, creating a path for the two male gametes now to enter the embryo sac. So the two male gamete nuclei enter the embryo sac. Now, one of the male gamete nucleus fuses with the egg cell. The egg cell that is here. To form a diploid zygote. That is one of the male gamete nucleus. The second one, or the other male gamete nucleus, fuses with the polar nuclei. To form a triploid nucleus. I want to summarize this here without erasing the diagram so that we can be able to see. So we are saying first male gamete fuses, combines with the egg cell, and it forms a diploid zygote. I'm summarizing what we have said here. To form a diploid zygote, then the second male gamete nucleus fuses with the polar nuclei. And this one forms a triploid nucleus. Since there are two fertilizations that are taking place, that's the first one and the second one, we call this double fertilization. So this constitutes double fertilization. One of the male gametes fusing with the egg cell to form a diploid zygote. The other second male gamete fusing with the polar nuclei to form the triploid nucleus. So that is what constitutes double fertilization. Now, the diploid zygote that has been formed there becomes the embryo. It's the one that will later become the embryo, having the plumule and radical. And the triploid nucleus develops into primary endosperm. So that marks the end of double fertilization. So what we have discussed is what happens from the time the pollen grain lands on the stigma, sticks and absorbs nutrients, forming a pollen tube. The tube nucleus takes a position at the tip of the pollen tube, like we have illustrated. The generative nucleus later divides mitotically, that is by mitosis, to form two male gamete nuclei. The pollen tube continues to grow down the style while absorbing nutrients from the neighboring cells. Finally, the pollen tube enters the embryo sac through the micropyle, the opening that we have shown there. And the tube nucleus disintegrates, creating a pathway for the male gamete nuclei to enter the embryo sac. One of the male gamete nucleus fuses with the egg cell to form a diploid zygote, just like we have summarized it there. The second male gamete nucleus fuses with the polar nucleus to form a triploid nucleus. So that's what constitutes double fertilization. The diploid zygote becomes the embryo, having the plumule and the radical within the seed. And then the triploid nucleus develops into a primary endosperm. So we are going to stop there and have a short assignment on what we have learned. So the first question in the assignment, describe double fertilization in flowering plants. And this is a question that can come as an essay, requiring one to explain from the time pollination takes place all the way until fertilization is completed. Then, number two, state the role of generative nucleus during fertilization. So we are going to stop there and continue next time. Goodbye.